Oysters. We love to eat them. We don't necessarily love to shuck them. But this delicious shellfish is much more than just a gastronomic treat. Oysters filter pollution from water as they eat. Here in New York, oyster beds once thrived and kept New York Harbor clean. They even protected our city from storm damage. When Henry Hudson arrived in what is now New York City back in 1609, there were approximately 350 miles of oyster reefs in our waters, nearly one half of the world's oyster population. But the beds started dying out due to pollution and overfishing. Now, an unprecedented program on Governor's Island has an ambitious goal: to restore New York Harbor's oyster population to its once glorious past. As part of our ongoing multi-platform public media reporting initiative, Peril and Promise, The Challenge of Climate Change, we'll look at a new film called Take Back the Harbor. Follows the unlikely teenage foot soldiers and their teachers at a remarkable public high school that teaches conservation and leadership of the waterways, alongside subjects like math and English. Take a quick look.
BOP is the Billion Oyster Project. You hear Billion Oyster Project and then people are automatically like, oh, what's that? Oysters are good for the harbor because they filter gallons and gallons of pollutants.
We just got water from the harbor. We went out with a bucket and we got it. And then we put like 20 oysters in. And within 2 hours, it was clearer than it was to begin with. And by the next day, it just looked like regular water. Oysters definitely help. Definitely.
And here to tell us more is the film's award-winning co-director, Christy Jacobson, and student featured in the film, Brian Campbell. It's nice to have you both here with
it's
us.
It's great to be here. Thank you.
It's a great film. But this is a really interesting story. And Christy, I'm going to start with you, because you've had such great success doing so many marvelous films.
Thank you.
So the question is, what drew you to this subject for a film?
Well, you know, my co-director, Roger Ross Williams, and I had just both completed kind of epic films, and we shared a producer in Julie Goldman, and we were talking about like sort of trying to look forward. And this was in 2016 when the kind of the US was changing. And an executive at Discovery heard on NPR a story about the Billion Oyster Project. When I learned about it, I was like, okay, a bunch of kids in New York City are gonna get 1 billion oysters in New York's harbor by 2035. That sounds outrageous and impossible. This is such a dirty waterway. And so we were kind of intrigued. And once we landed on Governor's Island and met among the many students we met on our first visit was Brian. It just became evident that the passion of these kids was like something we really needed to try and capture and share with the world.
Brian, let me ask you about the school, right? It's very special and very different. And New York has these specialized schools, but I suspect people haven't heard of yours. Tell me about it.
So basically, New York Harbor School is a school based on the marine industry. We focus around the Billion Oyster Project, as you know. So it's broken into six CTE programs. So the first year you get to like fill out every CTE program. Well, it's seven now, but it's six when we first started. Towards your sophomore year, you get to choose. So the six are vessel ops, aquaculture, marine bio, scuba, MST, and ocean engineering. So we all have a part in the Billion Oyster Project.
So you're doing that, and you're also taking, as I mentioned in the intro, your traditional high school subjects.
Yeah, so math, English, history, science.
So you're a busy guy.
Yeah, definitely.
Let me ask you to shift from your role as a student for a moment and become the professor, the teacher for us. I mentioned in the introduction a little bit about oysters and oyster reefs, but what did you learn about them that they provide to us in terms of our society and our culture and, most important, our environment?
So when I came to school, I didn't know anything about oysters. I didn't even know they filter water. So now being involved with them, I know that they filter water and they filter up to 50 gallons a day, which is a lot. So if you have a billion of them, right, I imagine how fast you can filter out the whole harbor.
So Christy, tell us about how you decided you were going to film this.
Yeah, so it was a challenge from the start because it's this extraordinary school with hundreds of students, incredibly passionate, and teachers. And we started filming in a couple of the classes, and it quickly became clear that it wasn't just one student's story, that Brian is one of many students at the Harbour School and that we wanted to tell the story of the students. You're the future and you seem to get more than anybody that this planet is in peril and someone's got to do something about it. And it was really amazing for us to capture you at work. Brian was a vessel ops major, so he's like operating and fixing the boats. And then there's kids scuba diving and actually growing oysters. So we just wanted to elevate you all and kind of get out of the way.
Brian, what'd you think about the idea of having them following you and filming you and turning this into a documentary?
I enjoyed it at first. I still do enjoy it. Because when you're so focused, like, it's hard to focus on what you want to focus on. Do I focus on the camera? But then you got to realize, all right, I got to stick to work. So it was a challenge, actually. But
if you're operating vessels, you got to focus on your vessel operating.
Mm-hmm. It's a wonderful film, and it's a great, in some ways, it's an adventure film as you're watching it. But I'm going to ask you a last question here, Christy, a question I ask filmmakers all the time, and that is, especially documentary filmmakers, you know, this is a journey. That and it was a year long journey, and you're taking us on that journey. It's a journey of discovery for us. But I've got to assume that you learned some things that you discovered that might have surprised you along the way. So as you look back on it, what do you think was sort of the most surprising element that you discovered?
Yeah, I mean, it was a journey, as you say, and I think that for me personally, sort of. I live in New York City. I've lived here for 20 years, and I didn't feel as connected to the water as I should. And also just to see that, like, the five boroughs of New York City and communities of people from all different types of homes, socioeconomically, racially, religious diversity, all these kids came together and really worked together to solve this kind of epic problem. And so I think that I felt like a kind of genuine inspiration. Like, I know it sounds cliche, but it's just true. And that surprised me because I wasn't really ready to feel that kind of optimism.
Well, as you said, we forget we're an island in this area, but it's just a marvelous film. And you get that sense of discovery and passion and surprise and certainly learning. So it does all the things that you want a documentary to do. So Christy, fabulous work yet again that you've
done. Thank you.
And Brian, you've got a future. You're at SUNY Maritime right now, but you've got a future as a star in these documentaries. We'll get you back
in. This afternoon.
Oh, yeah. So in that case, you're really dedicated. I want to thank you both. Again, fabulous work and a pleasure to spend some time talking with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And a reminder for you folks out there, Take Back the Harbor airs on the Discovery Channel on December 18th at 8 p.m. For more information on the Billion Oyster Project, you can visit our website at metrofocus.org.